We express our thanks and gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator, cherisher and nourisher of this universe. And thereafter we convey abundant peace and salutations upon our noble master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is indeed another great opportunity for us to offer this congregational prayer on this blessed day, Sayyidul Ayyam, the best day of the week, and that is the day of Jumu'ah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to continue giving us these blessings so that we execute and carry out this religious obligation as far or as long as we are breathing, inshallah, until we meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have come out in this weather for your love towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and towards your messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Some people are locked up in the dorms. They are indoors fearing this extreme weather, but forgetting that the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had also sacrificed during extreme weather when the sun was burning, literally burning, in that desert heat, the heat of Arabia. Alayhi salam goes on the battle of Tabuk, and we understand what took place and what transpired in the battle of Tabuk. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls it the days of hardship. Days of hardship, not only because of lack of resources. We did not have enough resources, yes, but because of extreme weather. So, being out in this weather, it is hard, but we understand that the reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is immense, and we cannot hope for anything besides the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That being said, we all know that we are currently in the month of Rabi'ul Awwal. And the month of Rabi'ul Awwal is generally the month where Muslims across the globe express their sentiments of love and affiliation towards the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because we believe, as historians has recorded, Ibn Hisham, the giant historian of the Islamic, that the Islamic era had ever seen, he writes that the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was born on the 12th of Rabi'ul Awwal, and his demise also took place on the 12th of Rabi'ul Awwal. However, for the purpose of knowledge, the date, the accuracy of the date is debatable amongst the scholars, but the month is unanimously agreed. Now, for those who celebrate the birth of Ali salam, doesn't it make it problematic? Doesn't this create a big dilemma whether we should celebrate his birth or commemorate his demise? If he was born in the same month and died in the same month, we are stuck in the middle. Should we celebrate his birth or commemorate his demise? What we know from the Sunnah is that the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam himself has never ever celebrated his birth. He has never celebrated the birth. What we have read, and we know that it's authentic, is that the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has discouraged the Ummah from having unreligious celebration. And we can go on and on. Al-Bukhari, Al-Muslim, when alayhi salam entered Medina, what did he find? He found the people of Medina having unreligious celebration, and he put a stop to it. So our deen, قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ. My life is governed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not governed by my ego. My life is not governed by that ruler that came along after the 4th century, some say 7th century, who invented the mawlid of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Do you claim that you have more love for alayhi salam than Sahaba? When Sahaba Ridwanullah alayhim ajma'in themselves have never celebrated the birth of alayhi salatu was salam. And these are people that they only gave the money for the love of alayhi salam, but they gave the blood. What a fake claim. So we walk the path of our heroes, the path of our role models, those of Abu Bakr, As-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, Umar bin al-Khattab, Uthman, and Ali radiallahu anhu, and all ashab of our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we see people going and dancing, exchanging gifts in the name of the celebration of the Mawlid of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I say to those people that your claim could be true, but where are you during the Fajr time? Where are you when it's time for you to hold on and suppress your anger? Where are you when it comes to your relationship with your wives, your children, and your community members? When it suits you to follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, then you say, you claim that you love him. But the Quran does not give the definition of love alayhi salam for celebrating birthdays, or celebrating his birth, or commemorating his demise. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبُكُمُ اللَّهِ. If you claim that you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ. If you claim that you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah has tested you. Allah has tested you and I to prove our love towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How should we demonstrate our love for Allah? فَاتَّبِعُونِ. So follow the footsteps of alayhi salatu wasalam. Follow him in his interaction with others. Follow him how he ate. This is Muslims eating with the right hand today. And this is becoming an acceptable custom. But alayhi salam says, whoever eats with his left hand, then shaitan is partaking that meal with him. We see Muslims not seeing a problem with their children not praying on time. It's acceptable. But is this what alayhi salam had told you? When you have those conflicts in your homes and you cannot come to compromise based on that sunnah, the same sunnah that you love to claim, and here you're breaking the sunnah, but there you are celebrating. So our message is that if we truly love alayhi salatu wassalam, then we should demonstrate that love by following the footsteps of al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam. With this message, I would like to encourage each and every one of us today in this month of Rabi'ul Awwal, when everyone else is confused by holding this celebration, big celebration, we see what's happening around the world. I want you and I to start reviving one small minor sunnah in our life. Start from today. And your niyyah is not because you want to celebrate the Mawlid of alayhi salam. No. Your niyyah is because you want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to love you. Your intention behind this, you want to be close to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on Yawmul Mahshar. Your intention, you want al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to intercede on your behalf. Remember how Sahaba Ridwanullah alayhim ajma'in demonstrated their love, their unconditional love for Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wallah, they did not demonstrate their love by celebrating the birth of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, what he says, Awsani khalili bi arba, my khalil, my bosom friend, referring to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, has given me four advices. One of those advices is that I should never go to bed without making mention of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know what Abu Huraira says? He says, from the day that alayhi salam gave me this promise, I did never abandon this advice of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that is sunnah. We're not speaking about wajib and fara'il. Umar radiallahu anhu will conclude on this note. He goes to Persia with that boy that accompanied him on this historic journey to capture, not only capture, but take control of Masjid al-Aqsa. He walks in there and a reception was arranged. And when he went, accompanied by Sahaba, giant Sahaba, Abu Ubaidah bin Jarrah radiallahu anhu, and he wants invited to a big reception. In this reception, you know who was the host? The patients themselves. The patients hosted this reception. And meals were presented. As Umar radiallahu anhu was partaking this meal, one morsel of food fell down. And we know from the sunnah. If a morsel of food falls down, what should you do? Pick it up. Or maintain, you know, hygiene, pick it up. And that is part of your hygiene. So he picks it up. And one Sahabi whispers to him and he says, Amir al-Mu'mineen, what are you doing? You're going to embarrass us. You think this is against the culture here. You know, sometimes we say, just go with the flow. This is culturally acceptable. Umar radiallahu anhu says, Ma kuntu li ada sunnati an-nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam la ajl ha'ula'i al-humaqa. He says, I will never ever sacrifice one minute sunnah and lifestyle of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam because of these people that cannot understand the unconditional love that we have for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the true love of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in our code of dressing, in our code, in our eating, in our communication and interaction, whether in business, in a commercial world, or whether in a social life. Ameen. نقول ما تسمعون استغفر الله لي ولكم وللتائب من ذنب كمن لا ذنب له استغفر الله يستجب لكم.